Hi everyone, this is Patty, and I'm back today with video 2 of the Loose Spine Mini. And I'm going to pattern a lot of the pages over this Cowboy and Indians one that I did. So the next page, the first page on the inside, was the top and bottom flap, which is a super simple one. So let's make it. And what I want to show you is I took Vintage Photo and I inked all the edges of my spine and hinges. And then I inked in the inside part, not the part you're going to fold up, although you could ink it too, but you won't see any of it, because this is what your pages are going to adhere to. But this is the part that's going to show here between the pages. And I just thought it might look a little more finished with some ink on it. I also went all the way around the outside edges. You're just going to see a tad of this on the inside of the book, but it just makes me feel better, warm and fuzzy. So do it if you want, and if you don't, you don't have to. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is we need to cut two pages. Our hinge is 5.5 inches. So our pages are going to have to be 5.5 inches. Now we can alter what our covers are going to be to allow us a little bit more room at the bottom or the top or the side if we decide we want to put mats in. But we want our pages to be the height of whatever our spine is, our hinge is, and the width, you can make it whatever you want. But I'm going to do with a 5.5 inch square. This one happened to be a 6 inch square with 6.5 inch covers. The reason I like the 5.5 is that you can get this, you can get 4 out of one sheet of paper, and if you're turning over anything, you have a 1/2 inch to play with to make a flap. So whatever you like. So anyway, this is our base page, and as I said at the ending and the beginning, at the ending of the first video, I like to put everything on mine and then glue it on. If you prefer to glue yours on first, like this, and then build your page as it's glued, whatever floats your boat. There's no right or wrong. So you're going to need one of these for the first page. You're going to need a flip down and a flip up. So these are going to be each 5 inches wide. You're going to need two of them. 5 inches wide. And they're going to be 4¾ inches wide. And then you're going to score it at 4¼. This is going to give us this flap part here that flaps up and down. I like to miter my edges. It's just not quite so much bulk in my book. Entirely, again, up to you. And again, I went all the way around the edges with the Vintage Photo. So let's glue that to the top and the bottom, and then we'll go from there. Now, you can glue it over the top like this, which I've done numerous times. But it does create more bulk in the top, whatever you're gluing, whichever edge you're gluing over. Last time in the Old West book, I glued it to the page on the inside. That worked great. So this is 5.5, and this is 5. So I have a 1/4 inch to play with. So I'm just going to take a marker, and I'm going to, now is that right? 5 and 5.5. Yes, I have 1/4 inch. So I'm just going to kind of mark loosely here and mark loosely here at my 1/4 inches. I'm going to turn it around and I'm going to do the same thing. So this is going to kind of give me a guide mark as to where I want to glue this. I want to glue it between those two marks because then I'm going to have an even space on both sides. I am using Art Glitter adhesive. This is a liquid glue. If you aren't familiar with it, I would say stomp right over there and get some. I get mine from Country Craft Creations, which if you're not familiar with them, Tammy Merrill has an online store, and this is great. This stuff is just amazing. In fact, I used to be an avid ATG user and Sequane tape. And since I've started using this, I rarely use the others because even for my, even for adhering the base of my spine, Wow, you just can't get any better. I think I'm going to turn this other light on too and see if that gives us a little bit more light to the situation here. Okay, so I have glued that between my two marks here. If you have any marks left, now is the time to get your handy dandy eraser out and get rid of them, because you're not going to want pencil marks. I think our decorative paper is going to cover it up, but we don't want to take a chance. Now we have the other one, the bottom one. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to miter these edges off so we don't have quite as much bulk. And when you do that, you want to make sure that you are mitering on the inside of the score line. You do not want to cut any of that score line off, or then you have a little problem. So let's get rid of this. I'm going to be using magnets today. You can buy basic gray magnets in the Scrapbookers or the Country Craft Creation store. I'm using some magnets that a friend gave me, which are very comparable to the basic gray, but I didn't have any of those left, and these work wonderfully. You do not have to have magnets. You can use a tie closure, or you can just let it flap in the wind. It does not have to be. Everything that I show you is suggestions as to how I do it. That by no means means that's Hoyle and that is the only way to do it. Absolutely not. There's 10,000 ways to do everything. You do what is comfortable for you. Again, I'm going to erase my little tick marks so I don't have them showing. Now, we have our flap down and our flap up. We want decorative papers on everything, but we also want a magnet so that when these flap up and out, down, they're going to not be like this. They're going to stay together. Now, I have a tendency to use these in place of one magnet. I've shown this in a lot of my videos, but I'll tell you about it again. These are called tin roof caps. This one is a 2¾-inch tin roof cap. They use them in roofing materials. Don't know what it does. And it's quite thin. You can see how thin it is here. But it is just a piece of tin. Your magnets will... Well, you can see here I've got some magnets stuck to it here. And that way I don't have to use four magnets. I can just use two magnets on the top and let it stick to here. Sometimes I use this and a magnet, depending on just how heavy a closure I want. But today, I want it so my top magnet is going to come down and hit it. And I want it, I'm going to put a little doodaddy thing over here over the top. And I want it so this is going to hit it as well. So I want to make sure that if I put this in, and if you don't have these, I got mine at Home Depot. They ordered them for me, shipped them to the store free. If you don't have something like this and you're using magnets, that's just great too. But since I have them, I thought I would use them. And this is just about, let me make sure again that that's going to be the right spot. Yeah. So I'm going to glue that down, and mine is just right above the seam. You want to, when you're using magnets, you want to have them as close to one another as possible without too many layers of paper in between. Because when you start building up and you get more and more layers of paper, your magnet gets harder and harder to stick. So we got the base part done. We need a piece of decorative paper here. This is the Authentique. Do I still have it on here? This is Authentique Tricycle Red. The one side like this and the stripey poo. I'm going to use this side on the inside, and I cut this, I believe, at 5 1/8 inch square. So it really fits in there nice and snug. Now I cut my top panels, my decorative top panels. They were a little bit shy. I wish I had cut them just a little bit bigger, but I wasn't going to waste paper and cut them again. They're perfectly fine. I just have more of an edge. So we're going to cover this up, trying to get a pretty even border of cream all the way around. But don't make yourself crazy. You're going to be putting pictures on here. You're not going to see that. Eyeballing is fine. Now, for the outside, I love this paper. You have to kind of close your eyes because on the back is the cut apart stuff, but I love this. By the way, I am using Authentique, come here, Authentique stitches for the demonstration of this book. And this Blessings that we're going to be using on the front is from this side, Stitches 8 two-sided paper, this is what it says. And it's this part right here that I cut out. These are from the back side of this panel. And you just, I lied. Where is it here? Come on. Oh, it's the back side of this panel. Here it is. And I just kind of had to close my eyes and cut because there's something pretty on each side. So you just do what you got to do. So this is going to be this flap. And my magnet needs to go on the inside here so it will adhere down. And the same way with this one. So what I like to do is take a magnet. And I take a piece of, everybody does this differently, but I take a piece of wide tape. I happen to be using Miracle Tape from Viva Las Vegas Stamps here. This works good for this kind of thing. And I'm going to find where my magnet is, hopefully, right about in there, I think. And I'm just going to kind of let it drop so that it's magnetized. The sticky part of this tape is sticking up. Now I'm going to bring this down. Pop it on it, and there we go. Perfect placement for your magnet. And see, it will stick now perfectly. And the same thing, this goes up, this goes down, and then I want this magnet will be sticking here to hold that bottom piece close. So we're great. So now we just have to put on our decorative pieces, because remember our big magnet is right here, so this is going to come down. And if you do not have a big magnet, put another two little ones here. Do the same thing. Put your tape on, put the magnet on, pull your paper down, stick the tape to it, and the same way with the other thing, and it will be right where you want it to be. So let's put these on. I've inked around. I corner chompered with the 1/4 inch corner chomper on the edges, and then I'm just going to glue all the way around. This Authentique paper is absolutely stunning. It is such a nice heavyweight paper. Okay, now I'm going to, like I said, I have a little bit larger border on this. I was trying to decide if I wanted to add some lace because this is a sewing design paper, but haven't decided yet. Okay, then there's this one, and it's going to go, it's going to go this way. This. And then we need decorative papers for the inside, and for it I chose the back of this tricycle red one. This is I would assume two. I've already cut that off. So here's the inside this way of this one. Now you can either leave that tape across the backing, or you can pull it off. I like to pull it off because it's just a little bit more security, and I think I'm going to go around this way, and then I will go around the very outside edge of this. It doesn't take a whole lot of glue with the Art Glitter Glue. Oh, this is really, man, maybe I got it too tight. Wow, I think I did, people. I think this is just, I thought I measured it for sure, but let's see, maybe it will be okay. Let's see. Oop, don't do what I do what I say. Let's see if we can get it here. Boy, it's just not, no, I got to cut just a tad bit off, sorry. And it's sticky, gonna get everything sticky, doggone, doggone. Let's just take a little bit off. And now remember, I had quarter rounded that one, so I need to quarter round it again with the 1/4 inch here. And then I also need to run my ink around it, because otherwise I'll have a white edge. Make sure I don't have any glue on that. Let's glue it again. This glue dries so fast, that's the only bad thing. Doesn't give you a whole lot of mistake or play with, but I want a little bit of border showing. That's better. Make sure that when you glue it, you are above your fold line on the bottom. There we go. And then on this one, I'm going to do the same thing before I glue it. I'm going to take a little bit more off. So maybe an eighth of an inch is all I need. And I'm going to corner around the bottom. And you can see the white edge on this now, because I've cut it off, and we don't want that. See the white edge? I don't know if you can see it or not, but there is definitely a white edge there, so we want to get rid of that. Let's see how this one goes. Oh, much better. This one a little bit smaller than the top, but I'm not going to worry about it. Not funny. Maybe my tops and my bottoms weren't quite the same. Get the stopper back in there so it doesn't clog up on me. And we're going to put our decorative paper on. Make sure it's on the inside of the fold. Looks like I have that a little crooked here. There we go. And now it goes up and it comes down like that. But I have an extra thing here, because I took a brown. This is the Authentique Artist, or excuse me, the Artisan Paper from Country Craft Creations. And I made a, this is one of the cut aparts, and then a brown mat that I quarter rounded around it. I'm going to put some glue around it all the way. You could leave the top or the side of this open if you wanted to have an additional pocket. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to just make it a decorative element. And we're going to glue it all down, leaving a nice border all the way around. There we go. The good thing about using these tin caps, if you can get them, is that you don't have to be as precise as to where you're going to put your thing to line up, because you've got so much more in there. I'm going to glue this at the top portion, and then I'm just going to leave it free because it's got that magnet on the bottom portion. And we're going to put, let's see, where does it go to? Right above at this, so they don't tell. There we go. Like that. And then I'm just kind of eyeballing it to make sure it looks like it's kind of in the center. And there we go. Now we have our flip up, we have our flip down, we have everything nice and magnetized, and we're ready to attach the first sheet to our hinge like this. You want to make sure you stay on the right-hand side of the crease line. And right now, we're only putting glue on this hinge part here. So we're going to put a nice bead of glue all the way around, staying in from the crease line. And then I'm going to just smooth this all out with my finger so I don't have any bumps or clogs or anything. And now we're going to take our page one, and we're going to line it up top and bottom on the inside. Make sure that you've got it on the inside and that you can fold it down, and you can fold it down this way. That's the secret. Before that glue dries, you want to make sure that you can get it down there. Now we're going to flap this over so that I can just use my bone folder directly on the back of this. And there we are. There's page one done already. Now, isn't that easy? So simple. There you are, guys. Page one. And when we get done with the book, then we'll come back and see what kind of cute little things we have left that we can adorn the pages with. But I kind of like to hold off on that so that I have enough to make sure I have enough to go through the whole book. Because I have, let me count and tell you how many pages I have here. I have two of each, I think. Two. That's the sticker sheet. Two. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. I must have had 18 pages, and I don't know what comes in the collection, but that will give you an idea of what I'm working with. And then I'm using the filler papers as well. So that's page two, or the first page, plus ink all of your edges, get everything prepped. Now we've already cut one, so this is going to be our back page here. And like I said before, when we attach this to it, we can leave the top or the side open. I'm going to be leaving all of the tops open to create room for another pocket here if I choose to put more tags in. And see, our spine is free, not hinged down at all. So there you are. I'll see you on the flip side for page two. Bye, everyone.